apologize if this is not the triad pairs that you were hoping would be.
I'm enjoying the story.
And so I was going through breakup, but I had a gig every night with amazing musicians, creative music in a style that I loved. I was making really good money. I had paid off all my debt, so it was just going straight to the bank, and I was miserable. And I had really, really considered engineering as a major in college, and I didn't go with it. My engineering teacher from high school was the one that said, no, you should go with music. I was in a 4-year program that I loved and was really good at. He was the one that said, go with music. I was just fresh out of school, and I was starting to really second guess it. I was thinking maybe I could become an EMT. Maybe I'm not cut out for this. Is this the best I can do? Go out on a cruise ship again, this time for 4 months.
Ooh.
I go to the South Pacific. I'm going through this breakup. I'm getting drunk a lot. At this point, I've never had a drink before I played. I've consciously avoided it. I've never played high or anything like that. And I'm on the ship, and you know, I'm drinking a lot, and a lot of other things are going around with that. I'm still playing the gig. The reason I'm drinking so much is because my boss, who's being paid twice as much as me, is a fall over drunk alcoholic. And we're there for 4 months, and it's the worst company I've worked for on cruise ships. And then I'm really like, well, I'm here to get away from this other stuff. And I figure if I'm gonna be miserable, I might as well be miserable in the South Pacific, you know? And I start seeing like the lifers and lumping myself in with that. I'm like, okay, I'm of the age now. I'm no longer a 19-year-old who's doing this between, I'm here for 4 months, I need something to get out of this. This audition pops up with the airman a note. I'm like, well, I don't really want to be in the military, but if I'm gonna be in the military, like that's the best band. That's the one to do. And there's this audition that's popped up on base. And whoever gets the gig is probably gonna keep it for 20 years at least. So this might be my only opportunity to do it. Start getting that together, and I start having this dichotomy of like, okay, I'm working really hard during the day and like partying really hard at night. And so at night crisis is like, am I gonna end up here? This is where I'm gonna be. During the day, the crisis is this the best I can do? I send in the tape, I get the audition, I go to the audition, it goes really well, I make it to the finals. The whole time, that whole like several month period, I'm living in 4 different states, I'm playing a lot of gigs, I'm on the road and I'm getting ready for this audition. I'm in New York, I hate it, it's just where I was living when I was getting ready for the audition. Take the audition. The whole time leading up to that, I'm like, do I really want to be? Is this the best I can do? And do I really want to be in the military? It's not to knock the military at all, but I'm just like, I'm 23, and I get to the audition, to the interview. I had 4 interviews as part of this audition. They said, you know, we're not allowed to talk about your age. I mean, obviously, but why now? I mean, you haven't. I was the only one that didn't have a master's. I said, don't you want to study more? I said, yeah. But if I was here, I could study like law or business or all these other things that I'm interested in. I don't get the gig, which means I'm going back to Mackinac, and it feels very much like a crushing, like, shit, here I am, stuck. This is the best I could do. I didn't even get the gig. And I'm there for about a week. I'm going to be there for 3 months, and I have other gigs set up, and but I'm there for about a week when I'm out, I'm having a drink. I'm actually taking it easy. I've had 1.5 beers, and then I wake up the next day and I don't know what happened, and I'm like completely just wrecked. Like I'm like sore all over my whole body, and I was drugged and taken home by someone, and then I had 2 months left on this contract where I said I gotta go up and play every night. And I've been afraid this whole time that this, like, that I was just gonna get stuck here. And here it is, like, here's what I get for not challenging myself to do this, or not being good enough to do that, or not getting this gig. If I had won this audition, I wouldn't have been, you know. And I started, like, really questioning some things. And that's a spiral, man. Then I'm like, you know, really drinking, And I'm still at the gig every night, but that's about the only thing I'm doing. I can't sleep at night. I'm like, I'm up till 4 or 5 in the morning. Then I'm up till 6 or 7 in the morning. Then I'm up till 9 or 10 or 11 in the morning from the night before. And then I'm kind of crashing and sleeping and whatever. And I'm just like, so I gotta go home. I went back to Ohio. And on a whim, I put my some applications out for grad school. I had 4 days before the deadline when I decided I was gonna apply for grad school. So I said, okay, very practical. I gotta decide. I gotta pick a school where I can pick my own audition material because I don't have time to learn anything else. And then I have to figure out what's really me for this audition material. But I've learned some nice songs that I really like from these really great people at this time. Put the applications out. I get 3 auditions. The very first one goes really well. And he says, I'd like you to come here. I'm not supposed to say this now, but I'd like you to come here. It takes the pressure off the other 2 auditions. They go really well. I get competing offers. I have this really great thing. And then I have to decide between New York and there. And it's... almost time to go, but
part 2.
Point was, I ended up deciding on Eastman because I was like, okay, I have to decide between a great place to learn, a great city, and a great place to keep working, or trying to figure out who I am. And after all of that, I just want to encourage all of you to never feel like that second thing is a waste of time. I was so dark. I'm gonna play these gigs, Yeah, give me your music, and I lost myself. And I went, and all of a sudden it was 2 years of validation. It was like, okay, I'm here, I've put out the money for this, like I'm taking a loan, even with a great scholarship. Fuck it, like I'm good enough for this. And it started propping me up with some stuff. Because for the first time in my life, I'm the older person in the room. And there's 18-year-olds. And I was like, man, I forgot what it was like to be around 18-year-olds. You guys suck. Even though, I mean, you're amazing at your instruments, but you guys just suck. You're awful. Grow up. I was never like you. But starts to be this sort of a validating situation. I start doing these prison ministry things. I've never been involved with the church, really. I play gospel music, and I've never really had it. But because I play that music, I get called to do a prison ministry thing. And I go to the very first prison I ever went into. One of the women named Amanda was in there, and the correctional officers were telling me about her story. They said, you know, she's innocent. Like, legitimately, the evidence is there. She's waiting for a trial. It's tied up because of this, because someone who needs to be in her trial is in a couple other trials, and that's being held up, and their lawyers are really doing this, and whatever. She's innocent. Everybody knows it. And I saw her again recently. She's now been in there for 6 years. Never convicted of a crime. It's 3:40. We're going to have to end soon. But I was like, well, fuck. I don't have any problems. And then I was seeing a therapist, finally. You know, I went to this more expensive school, and one of the things they offered was a therapist. And it just so happened that the first semester I was there, my girlfriend had brain surgery, third week of the semester. My brother had a kid. My best friend had a miscarriage. My other best friend got married but was, like, really out of touch, like, couldn't help with anything. And then my main mentor, Bunchy Atkinson, died. In the first 10 weeks of my master's program. So I started seeing a therapist because I was talking to my teachers about it. They said, hey, take whatever time you need, but we have 15 students in the studio, and I just want to let you know there's other services that deal specifically with this. Anytime that you need in here to talk about that, let me know. Anything that you need to like pass up on, sure, fine. But for this specifically, there are professionals here to deal with that. Started seeing a therapist, got through all of that stuff, and then started talking about me. And I was brought that up. It was right after the prison thing. I said, you know, I I just feel so guilty. I've been like moping about like getting drugged or whatever. And here's this woman who's never been convicted of a crime. She spent 6 years in prison. In jail, actually, not even in prison, in a temporary holding facility where people are more transient and there aren't work programs and there aren't, you know. She said, does that mean that you don't have problems? Again, a validating thing. It says, no, you can allow yourself to hurt and all that kind of other stuff. I decided to do a competition. I had a lot of time to prepare for that competition, and that preparation was mostly like, well, who am I? What's the most, as my teacher said, figure out how to do you, have a good concert. There's going to be a bunch of people that do amazing things. Doesn't mean you're not amazing. Just do you, and you'll be fine. I won the competition. That paid my rent for the summer because I wasn't like getting paid for the work I was doing that summer. Validating experience. 2 years later, I have to do a concert. And all of this was supposed to talk about coming to the, like finding a way to just out of habit come to the instrument with some sort of like joy. Say like there's no reason to ever come here and say I'm not good enough. Or not today, or there's always something that you can do to say, heal me. You know, like, give me something back. You know, that was kind of the whole point I was gonna try and get to. I spent too much time talking about high school, I think.
Thanks for sharing.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.